Taking a look over the system information, we can see the sensors and other hardware information over there. As you can see, the model number of this device is HM Note 1W, and we have ARMv7 processor clocked at 1.7 GHz. It is an octa-core CPU, MediaTek 6592 chipset it is. And here we have the display resolution, which is 720x1280. At this much of display resolution, I did not face any pixelation on this device. Although the text, whenever you open a document with large amount of text, that will look like soft. It will not be very crisp and precise, but still the 720p display on this device does a pretty decent job. The pixel density is again not too high, but you will not notice pixelation on this device most of the times. We have Mali 450MP as the GPU on this phone, and when it comes to the sensors, we have 3-axis accelerometer sensor, proximity sensor, light sensor, gyroscope, rotation, linear acceleration, and then you have gravity sensor, orientation, and you also have magnetic field sensor, which does allow you to do precise GPS navigation at times from this phone. The Antutu benchmark score which we have got for this device is 32244, which is quite an impressive score. And in terms of day-to-day usage, I did not face any issues with this device. Here we can see this is how the ranking goes for this one. It is in between Xiaomi Mi 3 and Xiaomi Redmi Note. Again, this device is Redmi Note, but there is another version of Redmi Note, that is why it is listed as Redmi Note over here. But this device has performed pretty well in terms of the benchmark, and in day-to-day usage I did not face any issues. Even day-to-day usage, this device has performed pretty well. I did not face any issues on this device. However, there is slight amount of lag at times which I can notice, especially while running high definition games, but it is not that much to make yourself uncomfortable to use this phone. As far as available amount of RAM is concerned, out of 2 GB of RAM, you will get approximately 940 MB of RAM available. So on the first port, you will get 940 MB RAM available. As of now, we are not running too many applications in the background, but out of 2 GB, approximately 840 MB of RAM is free on this device, which is fairly good. And the device is responsive. You can play a lot of high definition games on this device without any issues. On NearMark, we have got a score of 61.4 FPS, which is one of the best score which we have seen for this utility on any other device. So again, in terms of gaming, it can handle high definition games pretty well without any issues, and it does a pretty good job in rendering graphics as well. We will just play some games to show you the difference. On multi-touch, this device supports 10-point multi-touch, as you can see. So now we are playing this game, which is called Temple Run OZ, and this is a casual game in terms of graphics, and this game is running fine without any issues. I can see the graphics very clearly, although I cannot see the shadow of the player. But in terms of the overall touchscreen response, the response from the touchscreen is almost instant. There is no problem. Visibility of the touchscreen is also good. Even if I tilt the screen like this, I can see the screen, so which is good. There is no problem with that. And this game is running pretty fine without any kind of issues on this device. Similarly, you can play some other games like Subway Surfer, which is also a casual game in terms of graphics, and these games can play pretty fine without any graphic glitch on this device. So as you can see, we are right now playing this game called Blood and Glory, which is a graphic intensive game, and this game is running pretty smoothly on this device without any issues till now. And as far as loudspeaker is concerned, the loudspeaker is fairly loud when I play this game. And I did not notice any kind of graphic glitch or any other touchscreen issue while playing this game. So there is no problem with that. The touchscreen has all the controls accessible, and I can play this game pretty fine. Graphics are also pretty crisp and clear. So there is no problem as far as clarity is concerned or anything else is concerned with this game. This game is running pretty smoothly without any kind of issues on this phone. So you can play this game on this device without any issues, as you can see. So as you can see, we are right now playing a high definition video from our channel, and this video is getting played at what resolution? Let me just find it out. So it is getting played at 720p. It can play high definition video at 720p as well as at 1080p. As far as loudspeaker is concerned, I can increase the volume to full. So the volume is full right now, and let's see how loud it is. So the loudspeaker is actually at the back side, and one thing I can say is that the loudspeaker is fairly loud, not very loud, which you might expect from a device like this. And the moment you place it like this on a table, the sound will get muffled and it will get partially blocked. As far as viewing angles are concerned, viewing angles are pretty good on this device. Whenever you take a look over at the screen while watching a video, you can see it from almost any angle without any issue. So viewing angles are good enough. The display is pretty good. Loudspeaker is decent, but not very loud loudspeaker it has. So this is something which I can say. And you can always amplify the loudspeaker if you hold it like this. If you actually hold it like this, you can actually block it as well accidentally. So the overall video playback and the multimedia experience on this phone will be decent enough.